Okay, in this section, it's time for us to start placing text on the canvas. We can use the artistic text tool to begin with. So in the tools panel over there, you can click on it or you can press T on the keyboard. That's the shortcut. When I click on it and I long press, you'll see there's another option underneath called frame text tool. Basically, think of it like this. Artistic text tool is for the big headlines, and maybe you've got a paragraph underneath. That's where you'd use the frame text tool. Basically, anything more than a couple of sentences. So, artistic text tool, let's begin. Now that I have it selected, you look up in the context toolbar. All of these options will help us to format our text in some way. So there's a couple of ways to get started, okay? You could just click on the page anywhere. Just click once and you see I'm ready to start typing now. All of these settings that are currently active in the context toolbar will apply to this, like so, 150 pixels font size, blue color for the font, Arial for the font family. So I will just start typing A, B, C, little c there. So that's one way of laying it down. Another way is to just click and drag. And this way I get to see the font size. Like right next to it, you see there, the dimensions. And when I'm happy with it, I can just let go. And now I can start typing. Artistic, there we go. So what can we do from this point? Well, let me head on over to the move tool. I can grab it and place it wherever I want. I can go up to the alignment tab and I can just center it on the document there and press apply. I can rotate it. And by the way, lots of these changes that we can make here apply to all the shapes that we've used before. So in a shape, you also get this handle. You can do this, you can squash it down, you can skew it like this, and you can resize it like this. And obviously this is changing the font size, as you can see above, it's changing. Okay, let's look through some of the options in the context toolbar. So the whole thing is selected right now, and I want it to apply to the whole thing. But if I just wanted it to apply to a couple of letters, I could just highlight them like this and then go up there and make the changes. But for now, I want it to apply to all of them. So I'm just going to press on the move tool and head on up. So over here, of course, is our font family. If I click on this, over on the left-hand side, it says all. That's all the fonts that are available on your system, your computer. And then we've got recent. These might be fonts that you might have used quite recently when using Affinity Designer. And then you've got used, which is the fonts used on your actual document. So let's say you've got maybe three different fonts on the go. It will show three fonts here. And then you've got favorites. So whilst I'm still in recent, so I want to show you. If you head on over to the right-hand side, you can see there's a little heart next to it. If you press this heart, that font would then go in your favorites. So you don't have to go scrolling through hundreds of fonts, but we'll leave it on Arial for now. And right next to it is font style. And of course, italic, regular, bold, italic, bold. I'll click on bold. So all the usual settings that you might know about already. And we've got font size. Of course, we know about that. You could just cycle through it going up and down like this, or you could just enter the amount yourself, maybe 200 you'd write there. Let's make it 250 actually. And of course you've got bold, italic, underline, all of those things that could just be toggled on and off. Very quick and easy. Of course you've got color as well. So you can choose whichever color you want and you can add a gradient, but I'll show you how to use that in a bit with the gradient tool because it's much easier. And of course you've got all of these other options here, but one of the most important ones is aligning. So let's say right now, it doesn't really matter which one I press because I've only got one word there. But if I just click on the end there, I just double tap, you see I'm ready to start typing again. Let's say I press return and I start typing in text. So now it becomes apparent that this is all aligned to the left. This text word is not in the center. So I can head on up to align and press align to center there. And also you can just highlight individual words in there and go ahead and change the font size. So maybe I want it to be about this big and I can change this font color as well. Like this. But I will say that I really don't like playing around with two words in kind of one text box. I prefer to just press Command Z. I'll go back. Yeah, so I prefer to just copy and paste like this. I'm just going to hold down Command as I'm dragging that off. And then I can make the changes to this. So maybe I just write text here. And then it's a little bit faster for me to kind of move around and place wherever I want. If, however, I did have text written underneath there, and let's say I pressed off and I pressed on again. When I change the color of this, it's going to change the color of all of them. And I'd have to actually go in and select that one and then change the color of it. I'd rather work separately. So I've got two different layers here. And what else can I do to them? Well, we can stylize them somewhat. We can head on over to the stroke tab over here and start applying a stroke. So I'll just click and drag that up. And then we can go and change the color of that by going to the color tab, clicking on the stroke color, and then maybe we'll make it orange and make it a little bit thicker. So I'll go back to stroke and whack that up. So you can play around with the stroke width, etc. Let me zoom into that. And remember, you can play around with the order of your stroke and, you know, just play around with the different alignment options that you have there until you get the one you want. Obviously, right now you can see it's kind of rounded on the corners there. You can click on the sharp one over there, the miter join or the flat one. Up to you, get creative. But I'll just whack that down a little bit so it looks better. So what else can I do? Can I use a gradient? Yeah, sure, you can use a gradient. For now though, I'll just get rid of that stroke so it's more obvious. Okay, let's apply a gradient. So we just head on over to the left-hand side. And you see it says gradient tool there. I can click on it and just drag it like this. And I can choose the different colors I want from it. So I could just go up here. For the left side, I'll choose like purple, and for the right side, I'll choose a lighter blue. Something like that. There we go. Back to the move tool. So I've applied a gradient. Easy enough. Anytime I want to make a change to it, I can press G on the keyboard to get to the gradient tool again and then make my changes. So one of the things that you'll use quite often if you work with text is just like kerning. So there is an actual extra panel for this, and I'll show you where that is. But a short way and quick way to do it is just to, you see these two, the R and the T are quite close together. If I just double click in here, I'm ready to start typing again. Now I can just hold Option on the keyboard and just click on the right arrow or left arrow just to space it a little bit more evenly. And then I can use the right arrow key to kind of shuffle along and maybe make some more changes to the spacing between these letters. So this is another quick way of doing it. But if you really want more options, you can go ahead and reveal different panels. So there's quite a few that are hidden right now. So if I go up to Window, and then I go down to Text, see all of these are different pop-up boxes or panels that we can choose. So I will just choose Character for now, because this one's quite useful. And you see when I've clicked it, it will pop up there. If I want, I can actually drag it into my studio down here and like dock it. You see like where it's light blue there, or I can dock it up here. But I'll just keep it next to the text for now. So with this one, of course, we have even more options. And you see down here, we have the kerning set to auto right now. Type in the values you want. You've got tracking and baseline and all these other ones that you might be used to if you're used to working with text. But just so you know, these are here and you can dock them in your studio wherever you want. Or you could just simply click on the X and get rid of them once you're done with it. Okay, another thing is you can actually convert this to curves. So obviously I've applied a gradient to it. And by the way, you can still keep typing and the gradient will be there. So I can just type in gradient. Ooh, things are getting big now, aren't they? So let me zoom out a bit and just resize that. So you can see I'm still typing and the gradient is still revealed. Let's say I'm happy with what I've done here and I actually just want to convert it to curves because maybe I want to make some additional adjustments, like maybe making a really long T or something. Well, I can just right click on it and I can go down and press convert to curves right here, or I can just hold down command and press return. And if you look in the layers panel now, I'll just get rid of this extra text so it doesn't get in the way. So if we look in the layers panel, if I open this drop down arrow, you can see all of the different letters are individually in a line here. This is good if you want to, maybe you just want to make this one slightly bigger, and maybe you want to head on to the node tool and maybe like squeeze these in. By the way, I have no idea what I'm doing right now. Just showing you can change a few things. So I'm deleting a few nodes there. Maybe that big T like I was talking about, I could just select those nodes, bring it up like that. And maybe I will just select those two nodes and bring it out like here. So there we go. You can do things like this. And maybe you don't want this big group anymore in the layers panel. Well, you could just literally select all of them like this, and then you can go up to Boolean operations and you could just click add. So now I could just drag it out of that group, delete that empty group. And now I have just one layer with all of these. I can continue to playing around with my gradient tool and get creative.